Imagine if you were given the choice to bring back one person or animal. The three choices are a 5-year-old child who died before their 6th birthday, the smartest man alive, Albert Einstein, who could create anything, or third, Lucky, your childhood pet, who's your best friend when you're a kid. Who would you choose? This is my great uncle, Kermit. He was 97 years old when he found out that he had skin cancer. The skin cancer was on his bridge of his nose and crawled up to his eyebrow. He had surgery to remove the infected skin, but they then replaced the skin with clones of himself. So taking one of his cells that was not infected, they were able to create a fabricated skin to place over the covering of the missing skin. Cloning should not be allowed, or you should not be allowed to clone an entire human, but cloning for the purposes of medical, for ligaments, tendons, skin, or even bone should be promoted. Why cloning should be allowed, or why human cloning should not be allowed? Charles Chai, in the article Cloning of a Human, says that the chances of having the human actually happen would be like setting up a baby in a rocket and having a 50-50 chance of the rocket exploding. The odds aren't very good, aren't they? Not only should we not be able to clone humans, but the animals that go with it. Everyone knows about Dolly the sheep. She was one out of 227 chances of survival. In the article, The Biology of Cloning, History and Rational by Robert G. McAnell and Maria A. Barndio says that not only humans should be cloned, animals should not be cloned either. The cloned animals that are put into this experiment during the nuclear transplant, which is one of the stages of cloning, die within hours and days of being born. And not just today has cloning been an idea. Way back in 1978, in the movie The Boy from Brazil, in the article Little Lamb, Who Made Thee, Sharon Bagley and Stryker McGuire talk about how this movie was about a mad scientist who wanted to create Hitler's. Taking one of Hitler's cells, they transplanted the cell into 94 other kids, treating them to the same life experiences as Hitler was, wanting to take over the world. As shown in the movie, the experiment goes wrong and has to put an end to his 94 clones. In my survey, one of the questions was, how many countries have banned cloning? No one got it right. Most of you said 20 countries. But in the article Medicine by Mark Barna, cloning an entire human is not fully banned in the US, but many states have jumped onto this bandwagon, and along with 70 other countries. Religion is a big part of the ethics of cloning. Stated from the article, How Close Are We to Cloning Time? By Frank Miel, he says, Christians are the most religious and say that we should not be able to play the role of God. We should not be able to replicate a human being. And a human being should not be produced in a laboratory. Making babies the old-fashioned way already causes enough errors. But with cloning, there are less chance of having an heir, but the errors are more life-threatening and having a less chance of the baby to live. Now that you know why we should not be able to clone an entire human, let's talk about the positives. In the article, Growing New Organs by David J. Money and Antonio Michaels, talks about how scientists are able to create fabricated skins, such as my great uncle who had the cancer. He had his own skin able to replace the cancerous. A along with cartilage, bones, ligaments, and tendons. Many popular athletes have torn ligaments or tendons. They're able to be back on the field to play their game by cloning of their cells. The man-made tissues and organs are called neo-organs. A person who creates these neo-organs is called a tissue engineer. This person would then inject injects the place which the infected area or the wound, and then replaces in gestation to create the bone, ligament, or skin, personalized to each person. He also states in the article that repairing a human is not like repairing a vehicle. It doesn't happen overnight. It takes years of practice to get it right. And just to have a practice skin clone can take months. Now that we know that we should not be able to clone an entire human, we should be able to use cloning for the medical purposes, such as ligaments, tendons, bones, or skin. And hopefully we never have to have a scenario of being able to choose between one person, a child, the smartest man alive, or your childhood pet.